all three for different reasons and at different times in that conversation. So there's more than three up here, but we got some help, some emotional and physical help up here. So I'm going to ask each one of them one question and let them answer it for you. I want you to kind of get a feel for where they're at. This is Andrew, Richard, and Joseph. These three are the three that will be baptized in this morning. So. So one point I would like to ask each of you, starting with Andrew, is before and after. It's a before and after question. Now that you've received Christ in your life, how has it made you feel differently about who you are?
I really feel like I found my true identity, and God's unlimited grace really saved me from a lot of sins, and I can't even put any words in it.
Amen. All right, Richard, same question for you. How do you feel differently now than before you received Christ?
Before, life was just unmanageable, just hard to live. Now that I found Christ, everything seems good. And hope.
Yeah. All right, Joseph. How do you feel differently now than before you received Christ?
I have to say I feel alive. Before, I mean, I just put my faith and wanted to find my emotions from temporary things and turn into a lot of unmanageability. And so I have to say I thank God for this whole process.
Amen. If y'all would move this way. This brother came to me Tuesday after our prayer time up in the house of prayer, just sobbing. He said, "Pastor Dave, I got to show you this note." It was a note from his daughter saying, "Dad, I'm so proud of you for going the distance." And he said, this may be his last Sunday with us because they graduate on Friday. And he said, "I just got to say a few things to the body."
First, I just want to give thanks to the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I can stand here today. 45 days ago, I walked through the doors of fresh wind and broke a man, not knowing what to do with my life in a million pieces. But today, I can stand here in front of you, dude. I am a child of God. Yes. But I just want to thank Lord, my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
All right, Andrew, do you repent of your sins?
It is.
And do you want to follow Christ the rest of your life?
Yes, I do, dear.
Take a bath, okay? I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Baptism is a beautiful picture of salvation. The water represents the cleansing of our sins by the blood of Jesus. When a person goes under, it shows death to the old life. And when they come out, it represents that we are new in Christ. Joseph, do you repent of your sins?
Yes, sir.
And are you going to follow Christ the rest of your life?
Yes, sir.
I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Immediately upon conversion, people follow the Lord in baptism. In
If you're here today and you've received Christ, but you've not been obedient to being baptized, I challenge you to look at what the Word says.
Richard, do you repent of your sins?
Yes.
And do you want to follow Christ the rest of your life?
Yes.
I baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I'm so glad to be here this morning. Amen. Just thinking about Andrew's answer. He said, I found out where my identity is. And if you've accepted Jesus, if you've accepted His grace, His gift of life, then we are a new creation. And one of those promises to us is His faithfulness. I was thinking of, He said, I'll never leave you or forsake you. And God is always faithful to His promises. So let's just come into this time of worship together, remembering that God is faithful. These songs deal with His faithfulness. Let's just praise Him for that this morning. So join us as we sing.